To dissect the starfish, you really have to be aware of two directions: the surface away from the mouth, the top surface, or sometimes called aboral surface, and that's identified by having the spines and then the madreporite here, and then the oral surface, which is where the mouth is, so the mouth in the center of the star, the arms, and then the 2 feet extending away in rows in these grooves. So to dissect a starfish, you want to put the mouth side down, so the madreporite up, and the best instrument is usually a pair of scissors, and you want to pierce through the endoskeleton here, the skin, and then just cut toward the central disc area. Just cutting along the side. As you lift that up, the digestive gland, the pyloric ceca, are going to want to stick to that. So if you lift it carefully and just kind of push those glands down as you go. Extend this cut to another arm, and you can leave that flap on there for now. Cut up another arm, and then you get up to the central disc area. You want to make sure it cut, so it's similar process here. Push those digestive glands down. Can actually remove them from a few arms, so it doesn't matter too much. And like I say, you just want to make sure that that's cut there so that that lifts off. And then just continue to yet a third arm. Always And again, you can lift this up. Now, this is probably the trickiest part of the starfish dissection. As you lift this off the central disc, it's going to want to sit there. It's going to want to stick to the top, so you want to try to push that down, either with a scalpel or a needle. As you pull that away, you want to try to down. Now continue cutting that structure. Now if you probably return to this side, you want to cut around the madreporite. So you want to go this direction over to where you've made that cut before. One more cut to go around this madreporite. There we go. Lift off this, has the endoskeleton.